Journal. Now, in the heart of Lake Turkana is a little-known island known as Longe’ch. Here, fishing is the main economic activity. However, due to overfishing and the use of unsustainable fishing methods on the island's beaches, the lake had in the past realized a decline in the number of fish. Now, in this week's episode of Eco Journal, Sharon Momanyi tells us how proper fishing methods acquired by fishermen in Longe’ch Island has yielded better harvest.
Very dry is what marks the semi-arid climate in Turkana, and one that accounts for the perennial drought and poverty in the county. But like an oasis in the desert stands Lake Turkana, the world's largest permanent desert lake. From Kalakol town, a 30-minute ride on a motorboat gets us to little-known Longe’ch Island.
Gentlemen.
A group of fishermen are hauling in the day's catch of fish. Business is looking up.
Hii uvuvi wa bahari imenisaidia kwa sababu baba yangu hakuwa na shamba, hakuwa na mbuzi ama ngamia kunisomesha mpaka nikamaliza.
Turkanas are mostly pastoralists, but here in Longe’ch Island, fishing is the main socio-economic activity, one that has seen people even from outside Turkana County settle here to do business.
The lake has been a life force to many who fish in the lake, both for subsistence and as a means of livelihood. However, the biggest problem for the fishermen in Longe’ch Island has been the use of inappropriate nets and fishing gear, which had led to a decrease of fish and fingerling stocks in the lake. According to Emmanuel Rimati, the fisherman chairman, fishermen in the area had gone to an extent of using mosquito nets in their fishing activities. This, coupled with overfishing, affected the economic earnings of the fishermen since they had no variety and stocks of fish to sell.
Ushauri sasa badala angalia hivi hii watu akiwa kitu kama mwaka 5 hivi hii vitu itaisha. Ushauri mbari nyingine samaki imeisha. Hii sasa hii bari ndio ile yote ndio inategemea.
In order to empower the fishermen to better and profitably utilize the lake, the Agency for Pastoralist Development conducted a 2-year training program that educated the fishermen on proper fishing methods.
We started working with the fishermen in Kalakol in the year 2012 with funding from ACT, and we did a program called Changieni Rasilimali CRM, and the main objective of the program was actually to sensitize fishermen in Kalakol and the neighboring beaches on the issue of sustainable management and utilization of the Lake Turkana resources, that's the fish.
Elimu nyingine ambayo pia tuliweza kupata ni kwamba tusiwe tukivua penye samaki usalia. Kama hapa kwetu ni Ferguson Gulf. Sasa tulipata pia elimu kuhusu hiyo Gulf. Sababu hapo ndio sehemu ambayo samaki usaana.
The training included education on legal practices including beach sanning and broodstock preservation, as well as controlled fishing to prevent overfishing, as cited in the Fisheries Act.
According to the Fisheries Act, the right size of the fishing gear is 5 inches, so that when you catch a tilapia fish, it has to be that size of my palm and beyond. But if you fish with using a net of 2 inches or 3 inches, 4 inches, it means that you end up catching a small fish, what we call fingerlings.
Once ukivua mchana usiku hazitafua sababu kuna vile kuna vitu vingi tafanyika usiku. Tukivua hata usiku kuna vitu kama uwizi wa samaki itaendelea. Pia tukasema hiyo ni mzuri kwa sababu itasaidia pia bahari kutunza samaki yenye iko kwa bahari.
The interventions are slowing paying off in terms of increased fish stocks in the lake, as well as increased attention by the communities on how the lake resources are utilized. However, challenges abound for this promising business here in Lake Turkana. With hardly any refrigeration available and only rough dirt roads to take the catch to market, the sure way of making an income from fishing is to dry each day's haul. Middlemen, who don't always offer the best prices to the fishermen, process the fish by smoking and drying them on the shores of the beaches.
Utusaidia tu ile tu kupata ile chakula na tu ile pesa kidogo ambayo si kitu ya kusaidia mtu kabisa, kwa sababu kuna vile kuna shida ya barabara. Hakuna wanunuzi wengi wanakuja pande ya kwetu. Bei ni mbaya, wachuuzi ni wachache. Sasa hiyo yote inachangia bei ya hii samaki kuwa kidogo.
A sizable number of the farmers has actually changed, and they have now shifted to proper and legal fishing methods. But the problem with the fishing is that people keep on migrating in and out. Today you will find people migrating from Lower Rangak because there's starvation there, and they come to Kaloko to look for space to do fishing. You'll find people from other places like Kalapata, maybe they are hit because of hunger, or people from Nakwamoru, they have been hit by raids, all their animals have been taken, so for survival they go to the lake. Now, that new group again is now what needs to be trained, you know.
Should the challenges be mitigated for these empowered fishermen, it shall then be only good things coming for those who bait. Sharon Momanyi for KTN in Longe’ch Island, Turkana County.